Okay, so what we have done in today's lecture, lecture 6 of module 3, is to look at the iterative methods for solving a linear equation A of the type AX equal to B. And now what I will do is use the next few minutes to summarize what we have done in this module. In this particular module, that is module 3, we have primarily covered computational methods for solving linear equations of the type AX equal to B. The first thing that we started off with was Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule involves finding determinants, and finding determinants is extremely computationally complex. As a result, Cramer's rule is not used beyond say the 4 or 5 dimensional systems. Okay. Using this Cramer's rule idea, we motivated a few things further. We said that if rank of the matrix A in AX equal to B equal to is equal to n, where n is the size of the vector x, okay, then we will get a unique solution. Okay. If rank of the matrix is not equal to n, if the rank of matrix A is less than n, then we need to check the rank of matrix AB and the rank of matrix A. If both these ranks are equal, then we have infinite number of solution. If rank of this guy is greater than rank of A, is going to be no solution. Okay. And then we gave a geometric interpretation of this also in terms of vector spaces. Next, we covered the direct methods. The first method that we covered very extensively was the Gauss elimination method. The idea of Gauss elimination is to use row operations to convert in the matrix A into an upper triangular form. What we also saw in the previous lecture of this module is that the computational effort required in Gauss elimination is of the order of n cubed. Okay. The next method we talked about was a Gauss-Jordan method. In Gauss-Jordan method, we use row operations to convert the matrix A not into a upper triangular matrix, but into an identity matrix. And whatever is left of the matrix B in the juxtaposed matrix AB is going to be the solution X. We then also talked about the LU decomposition method. The first part of LU decomposition is exactly the same as Gauss elimination. We use Gauss elimination to get the upper triangular matrix, and all the coefficients that are used in each pivot row are going to actually form the lower triangular matrix in the LU decomposition method. Then in towards the end of the lecture 5 in this module, we covered sparse matrices. Specifically, we covered tri-diagonal matrix, and to solve the tri-diagonal matrix, we covered an algorithm called the Thomas algorithm or the tri-diagonal matrix algorithm. The Thomas algorithm is similar to Gauss elimination, but it exploits the special structure of the sparse matrix, because of which the overall effort required in computing the solution using Thomas algorithm is of the order of n to the power 1 rather than it being of the order of n to the power 3. Okay. So that was what we discussed about the Thomas algorithm or the TDMA. And finally, in this particular lecture, we covered iterative methods and the geometric interpretation of the iterative methods. The first iterative method we covered was the Gauss-Seidel method, and this was the overall expression for Gauss-Seidel method. What we did was, for each equation, we took all the elements from the left hand side over to the right hand side and used whatever is left as an iterative equation. So we started with some initial guess of x values, and we kept improving the guess by iterating it over this particular equation. This is an equation we saw a few moments ago. In Gauss-Seidel, we use the most recent values of x. That means for computing xi, we use the m plus 1th values of x1 up to xi minus 1, and we use the mth value from xi plus 1 up to n, because we do not have the m plus 1th values of xj at this point. Okay. So we use the latest value in computing xi in Gauss-Seidel method, whereas in Jacobi iteration method, we do not use the latest value, but we use the values from the previous iteration. And the change between Gauss-Seidel and the Jacobi iteration, I have just highlighted over here. In Gauss-Seidel, we got m plus 1 as the iteration number over here, whereas in Jacobi iteration, we get this iteration number m at itself. Okay. So these were the two main classes of methods, the direct methods and the iterative methods when solving the linear algebra. Okay. So with that, we come to an end to module 6. With that, we come to an end to module 3, and from next lecture onwards, we will start with module 4, which will cover solving nonlinear algebraic equations.